playing F1 2018. Second time we're doing this. Last time was the Monaco Grand Prix. This time we'll be doing the Canadian Grand Prix. I figured it was fitting, since that race, by the time this video was up, we'll have just concluded a couple days ago. So I figured, why not race Canada right now? So we're going to do qualifying here. I haven't done qualifying like this. Necessarily before. So, yeah, we're gonna go to the track and see what happens.
Checks complete.
I did one shot qualifying, so I'm gonna run rounds of qualifying first. We'll see what happens. Definitely ready to do this. I like that view, but I'm not trying to race in that view at the moment. Haven't raced the game in a couple of days, so it'll be fun to get back into right here in this video. Gotta get up to speed on the field this time. I don't know how many laps I'm gonna get on the field. I'm gonna do a lap or two of qualifying and go into pick up speed up qualifying to see if we're gonna get down.
Careful with the front wing, you've taken some minor damage.
I have no idea what I'm playing for. I'll see how fast our time is. Essentially, the deciding factor is if I stay out in 12 times essentially or not. How fast time is. Another thing I do want to state, I will use flashback in racing in Monaco. Same rules apply here, 3 flashbacks per race. The scratch and the 4th one. The 4th incident involving my car being damaged. It's happening. Rules apply in front of race at that point. Okay.
We have to replace that front wing. Box now.
Damn. I was doing so well. You were 5 place grid penalty as well. Also, I crashed before. This week is Canada making the sound. You got 2K19 playing, Golden State Warriors against the Black Raptors, facing the Canadian Grand Prix. kind of interesting how that's worked out. We're gonna box here and we're gonna try to fix stuff. See what we do from here. Here to try to get this car repaired. We are gonna fast forward in the foregone session. Right now we are 18th on the grid. Alright, so we've started up to 4 minutes to go.
All set. Everyone clear? Car to track.
We have 4 minutes here. Gonna get out on the track. Get this thing going. We did crash previously, which did hurt us. We have 18th in qualifying. The only lap that we could have crashed. The seconds after we smashed the wall and made contact with Lewis Hamilton, giving us the penalty. So wherever we qualify, if we're higher, we will drop that top spot. Anything from there, we'll drop that. We qualify 6 people on the drop spot. 7 people got 3, 18 got 2, 19 got 3. But anything from 15 or higher, we've got 5. So, that 5-spot grid penalty will hurt us, but I'm confident we can get into the top 5. I'd like to get pole just to not have to race our way through as many cars, because it's going to be tough to get by a lot of cars here. We have 2 minutes, 34 seconds left in the first round of qualifying. We're here on second lap. Okay, wow, that was fast. 1:16. Get the fastest lap. We can, I don't know how high up we do advance. I don't actually watch when we're on the qualifying, I can't see things on Twitter and Instagram. I don't really know how far I'm going to advance, but I assume we can cut off 5 cars to throw for 3 rounds.
You've just put in the fastest lap. Good job.
I'm really slow around the rest of the track. There's one section where you're supposed to brake a lot. I kind of mow the car through the turn a little bit forward. You speed up. Myself into the next round of attack. Keep the car clean for a lap here, get it back to the pit. And building that ground of qualifying. Essential. If you have another lap like that, put us in first spot on the grid, that'd be great. I don't really want to start with that. It feels better. Good lap time. So I will be fastest time of the race, and put us in position to Lewis Hamilton got no timing. Did he like ground or something? Okay. Qualifying round two. Do a lap. Let's go to the gold squad. Do a lap.
When you're ready, let's go.
Get the fastest lap. He does qualifying. We took the second car on the track. Get near the couple of seconds. It's definitely passed on this lap. Didn't want to pass him out, but I would have passed him when the last. There you go, my lap done. jump. We're gonna speed the time, get this session done. Slower lap than the previous one.
Less than a lap of fuel now. The tank is empty.
What? Less than a lap of fuel? What does that mean? Why am I out of gas? What? How am I out of gas?
To spend time repairing the damage to the car.
Let's look at the time on the top, make sure that you drop down from first floor to 10th. Anything below 10th, I don't think that it will. There you go, more cars have been eliminated.
Checks complete. Personnel be aware, we have a car leaving.
Alright, here we go. What the hell? Alright, I wasn't really paying attention. I was dragged by the... Very, very fast. going to be like, that's right about here next time. So we're going to climb probably maybe up to first in a couple of laps in this race, and yeah, I think we're confident though in stability. Canada's definitely a small track though. Not very much room to get past and move.
There's only one lap of fuel remaining.
For sure, we'll utilize these space and make sure we gotta make sure that time still says that I'm in first. Up at the top corner. Every car went out trying to get a lap in.
From the excitement of qualifying, here's a look at your top three. Verstappen, Raikkonen, and Valtteri Bottas. It's time to leave for now.
So, we're gonna see what we can do on this initial race start. We gotta get a dub here. We raced Monaco the other week, and did not go well. The second video, I think, in this summer series. And, it was a mess. That's about all I'm saying. It was an absolute mess. Even watch it.
We're here. Well then, after an exciting qualifying session yesterday, let's take a look at how the cars line up. Kimi Raikkonen's perfect lap yesterday sees him start from pole position, and Valtteri Bottas will line up alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Ricciardo, Vettel, Carlos Sainz, and Verstappen. They've taken a grid penalty. Hülkenberg, Perez, Grosjean, and Esteban Ocon. Leclerc, Magnussen, Fernando Alonso, and Van Dorn, Stroll, Hartley, Pierre Gasly, and Sergei Sorokin, Ericsson, and Lewis Hamilton rounds off the grid. And now, it's time to head down to the track.
So there you go, we actually start 6th to 5.
Right, let's be patient going into turn 1. We want to be in a good position for the rest of the race.
So we're
going
to start 6th, that means we're definitely going to drop to like 9.
Be careful with the front wing, you've taken some minor damage.
Make the leap best out of the Cobra 6, but, you know, I don't think we necessarily force anything and ruin our cars and stuff, but sure, that will be later in the race anyways. Okay,
good work. Great pass.
I need to press
the okay, clear.
Oh,
are you alright? Engine off. Engine off.
That was me being in. On different tires, so everybody, what did I do here? It looks like I just cut this corner way too hard and lose it. That's about it, yeah, cut this corner way too hard and lose it. Alright, we have one flash back to get us through 14 laps of racing. We'll be right back. out of the gun. Is it Ericsson? Maybe? Or Magnuson? I think it's Ericsson because there's one. I've used one there a second ago. I'm aggressive racing. If I just crashed another wall, that's all it was. Just like a capital wall. It's not a fine, but it's a big knockoff of the tire. Yeah. Big knockoff of the tire. The bumper. Wing. The wing. Kind of were forced to hit. Or forced to, but the whole thing doesn't really hurt. We had the super senior character. Super character. Castle Hunter is so hard because it's the same life. Crash and ruin the front wing and ruin the car. Because if I crash the car, that'd be my last car.
Some information on Sir Rodkin. They're slowing down. It seems like there's some kind of problem with their car.
And that would be nasty.
Yeah. Nice work, that brings you up a place.
Let me know how I want to do a F1 race here, because I want to be able to do a race on one of the videos where I'm not cranking. Not forced to pit. Monaco, they even attempt to try to get as far as they could in the race, and crashing out of the race. But here, that was dumb. That right there is the type of shit you can't see about me. Trying to block a dude. That is what gets me into trouble. Look at me again. But I'm used to doing it now. Not the video.
We're expecting rain in around 10 to 15 minutes.
I'm used to seeing it now. Having dabbled into the black. That's what I implemented myself into part of it, because I feel like it's appropriate to make this video a little more authentic to what we're doing and what the race is like for real. Obviously, with any flash race, it's got to help, but you know, I want to have a little more of that realistic. What just happened there?
That looked bad. Are you alright?
I want to have more.
Let me know you're alright.
To it where, you know, go into the race. So, yeah. I have no idea, Mike. Not to be that dude or anything, but I literally did not turn the car. So I'm not going to really count this one. As a flashback here, I was literally holding this thing straight. I know I haven't had an issue with this controller at occasional moments. You know that dude was like, whoa, my controller's so literally, that does happen to down the moment I play Overwatch when I'm flying. Slide around with the character though. Same with Minecraft and the controller. We work through. I'm not saying this episode is what happened, but I feel like I wasn't turning the car around. Okay, wow.
Motorhead has come in to put on the ultra soft tyre. Car Ahead is now running ultra softs.
That was insane. That was launching. So that will not count as a just due to the fact that they didn't have any control. Back in 9, do you know how many sort of content count with their semis over the back? Can you count over the semis over the back? Yes. Just because you can kind of drop them in. The qualified first, got a good penalty back to 6. And then
you've been awarded a time penalty for that last incident.
Time penalty there. If I didn't have one flashback on, would use it, get rid of that time penalty, get it from 15. But I'm not gonna. I just don't want to put myself in a situation where, you know, just late in the race, if you only have 9 laps to go, and we're at the halfway point now, we need to flashback. I don't really want to use all 3 until we get halfway, or when we're at halfway. So
our gap to the car in front is 4.1 seconds.
I don't think that's a good idea. So I'm not gonna.
Caution, caution. The virtual safety car is out. Reduce speed and maintain a positive delta.
Okay,
some information on Raikkonen. They have an issue with their car. They're going to be slow.
I don't really know what happened. This will help us catch up with some of the cars. We're going to have to compete with you for the win. Some of these guys, you know, you're not trying to compete with. It was an actual safety car.
VSC ending, we're going green. Maintain positive delta until the green flags. Daniel's in the pits.
A lot closer, but a safety car obviously doing its job on the left. Wow! I don't know what just happened, but I can see that going for the destroy my car. You did have a slight contact, I didn't know if you thought you did. The game said, yeah, contact, right? He had an issue there, he could have catched up and gone off one of these pass cars. We're just going to have a couple laps to go. Here we should be down to 7 laps remaining in this thing. Catch this guy, but he's 7 seconds behind. 7 laps. We'll make about a second a lap. That's why we got a safety car, it was really good. I remember the safety car did help us catch the signs of the right one, but had like a really far ahead of us. This point four, we really did cut it down. 8.7 before we had some sweet section of the track. Get close to it. There you go. 4.7. So we're at 6 in. And we're really coming down these turns. You can drive through faster turns than the average. So, one thing about it is always catch the
rain. Rain is forecast in just over 10 minutes' time. Rain in 10 minutes.
The rain coming in, I don't think we're actually a factor. Because the race is going to end in time. If it was 13 degrees or 10 minutes, we'd probably have by the end of the race, but we're 116. Right here behind him. Our goal was how we're going to get by without tearing up our car again. This time I have the replay or the flashback left in my pocket for a situation like this, where it's a pass for the most important, close the pass for the most important one hits.
Brilliant. Nice move.
We're going to stay there. Can do it in this turn. Real good. How out of town we do, he's moving behind us. I think that's it. With a slide, almost hit the wall. But we kept him behind us in that turn, but we really have a chance to catch up. Think he's gonna be gone. I mean, he's still gonna be in the range of DRS, so we do have to worry about that. But we'll never. We might always be able to make potential. Come up here, no challenge for position. In that case, we could have raced smart. And not crashed smart. Four laps. But from the 4th to 9th, we were really too fast. Definitely not going to hurt this car. That's what you keep.
What happened?
Right.
Let me know you're okay.
Situation like that. Failed block attempt here results in this incident. I do want to break this one down for you guys. Really explain what was going on. Because, you know, it's going to make a race. So, essentially, go here, try to block and fail. Try to just go here, slow him down. And this is me trying to cut in behind him. Clip him with the front wing. Sends me right in the wall. I don't think the tire actually made contact with the wall. Maybe wrong. Yeah, it didn't actually. But it's still broken. Either way, we're bouncing along the track here. And that's that. really hurt our cars, hurt our race. We don't have a flashback. To lean on now. If anything bad happens, that's it. Then you gotta keep cleaning the blood out for the rest of the race here. And keep cleaning from four to three more laps. It's interesting. I think sometimes I say words too fast. I think about some of the things I'm on, what I'm saying, how I'm saying, and I'm saying things way too fast, so it's kind of weird. It's not intentional, so it's not like it. I'm making up. It's really weird to... I guess, I'm driving this thing so fast.
We have 5 laps of fuel remaining.
I just naturally do it. So, I think that's the issue because I felt that, so I'm going to push it into the alright.
Are you alright? Engine off, engine off.
And then this happens. When I'm just sitting here thinking about something, not paying attention to what I'm doing, and I crash the damn car. We have 2 or 3 flashbacks. But I want to finish the race anyways. So, I guess that's a thing. And one of the flashback unit. I'm mad that I made a mistake in the participation unit. I had to use a 4 flashback. We used 5 in this race. A collision with Science Start. Collision with Action Self. A mistake with PS3 and PS4. One on the ground, still caught. Then crash with Bottas as well. But also right here in the game, there's a young man crashing the wall. Then when I wasn't paying attention. But either way, we're here about 16 of 18. We're going to wrap this race up to go. It's been a very eventful race, that's for sure. We had a bunch of issues to start qualifying first round, second lap, in a contest made for myself on Lewis Hamilton, which for Lewis Hamilton, I feel to back in the race. I had to command the race win, but I'm qualifying. I think it's not gotten all 3 rounds, but contest with Lewis Hamilton gave me a 5. Of course, as everyone knows, I'm not getting launch, so we got first spots there, so we went first, and then qualifying, so we got 9th, and then, like I said, just contact early. Besides the flashback, we have contact with contact there, ruining the front wing, contact with the right wing, Dale O'Brien and then the front wing, so they go box pretty early for the win, which I'm sure is having a good effect on the tires, as well as the tires have been on the car since 3, that's why we're back.
Looks like rain is inbound. We're expecting it in around 5 minutes. 5 minutes till the rain. We're leading our teammate by 11.2 seconds. This is your final lap of the race.
top spot of three. And then my system had a great slide where it passed, but then I lost it to it. It was great for the second time. It was passing back. And put ourselves in a spot where, you know, we're looking at. Really?
Are you okay? That was a big one. Confirm you're okay, please.
That sucks. Again, we will just continue this way. We will use our flashback, but here's the thing. I go here, make such an aggressive maneuver that I get stuck in a bad spot because I'm trying to go. I go behind him, I'm gonna go this way around him. And it forces me to, you know, start sliding around. Which really just hurts my car overall. I went past him here earlier. Not to ruin anything there. This time.
Race control aren't happy with your creative interpretation of track limits. They've given you a 3 second. That looked bad. Are you alright? Let me know you're alright.
You know, when you're getting out of the end of the race, it's kind of just like, you know, let's smash into the... Alright, let's end this thing now.
Okay, this is Jeff. I need you to stop cutting the corners. If you keep it up, Stuart will...
And that is that.
Absolutely fantastic. It's a brilliant result.
The first win we've had here on the channel in F1 2018. Second race that we've done. I'm trying to do these races essentially to sort of pair up with the race that happens on the Sunday before. So this one is Canada. We did this just a couple days out of the actual race. I don't know the winner yet because the race is actually tomorrow when I'm recording it. But you know, we're trying to get these races done around the time that the thing happens. So I believe France is in a couple weeks, so we will do the French Grand Prix as well. But with that, thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoy, or enjoyed, not enjoy, I hope you enjoyed. And we'll see you guys in the next one. Whoever brought us. Actually. That's it for today's Grand Prix. And from Antonio, we got a 5 second penalty.
See you again next time.
That's how he dropped down here, because he had the 5 second penalty. So that's gonna really hurt him there, yeah. Looks like it. Well, thank you guys for watching. Hope you enjoyed, and we'll see you guys in the next one.